welcome back. There's someone here to see you. Uncle Burroughs, this is the boy I was talking about.
Ah, about time. You're our dragon boy, then. The king filled me in. Call me Burroughs. How are you holding up?
Hi. It's, nice to meet you.
Oh, forgive me, Yuma. I should have mentioned. This is Burroughs, captain of the Knights of Astoria and an old family friend. Captain, if you're making a visit to the Seagull, that must mean you've got work for the Dragoneers, right?
Right you are, my lady. A hunting contract. Seems something big is out terrorizing folk beyond the walls.
What, a monster? More than your knights can handle if you're asking for a Dragoneer to deal with it.
Well, the Knights of Astoria... See, we've got our hands full with something else right now, so...
I see. By all means, then, let's petition the Dragoneers!
Hey, Sonya, there are other Dragoneers besides Kirika staying here, right?
Three of them, all told, yeah. Kirika and two others all use the Seagull Inn as their base of operations. And when the throne doesn't have official contracts to offer, they go around assisting the people of Marga instead. There's not a soul in Marga who can't tell you a story about a stout-hearted Dragoneer. You can always rely on them. Astoria owes generations of peace and comfort to their protection. By playing their harmonics, they can channel special magic and perform feats far beyond other people. All to keep the peace, of course.
Harmonics? Is that what you call those instrument weapon things Kirika and Excella were using?
Mm-hmm. Long ago, the Shining Dragon inside you gifted them to the Ancients so they could protect themselves. There are supposedly 7 harmonic armaments in all, 3 of which are here in Astoria. The Elves of Welland have another 3. And the last one's in the care of that Imperial Princess.
Welland? Oh, but isn't that Kirika's homeland? What's she doing fighting for Astoria instead?
Well, Astoria and Wellantine relations are peaceful. The Elves' ancestors lived here a long time ago, so we've been allies for generations. At any rate, I should go and see about this something big. You stay here where it's safe, Yuma.
You're going all by yourself?
I can't just demand a Dragoneer's time without doing any scouting first, now can I? It's my duty to aid them in my father's place, you know.
Be that as it may, my lady. Maybe take Yuma with you all the same, just to be safe.
Me?
Don't worry, Captain Burroughs. It's just a scouting op. You don't have to be so protective. Emma, could you make Yuma some tea? I'll be back before it's cold.
Ah, my lady, wait! And she's gone. Emma, why didn't you stop her? Now I have to figure my plans out all over again.
Plans? What in the world are you talking about?
Nothing. Yeah, I didn't say a thing. Now, how to fix this? Hey, Yuma! Little coward, are you letting the princess totter off into danger all on her own?
Huh? But she said she was just scouting, so...
No excuses. Get after her right now, boy. Hop to.
Wait, why? Why do I have to do this?
I'd do as he says, Your Radiance. Sir Burroughs is a very stubborn man. Arguing will only make him grumpier.
Fine, I'll go. I'm going.
Allow me to accompany you, Your Radiance. If we hurry, we should be able to catch up before Sonya reaches the gates.
Thank you.